What's up? What's up, everyone? Jason Flagel here, and I'm so excited because we get to unpack the top four ways that ChatGPT can help you as a software engineer. Let's go ahead and jump into it. And welcome back, everyone. So let's go into more detail on the top four ways that ChatGPT can help you as a software engineer. So the first one and the first way that ChatGPT can actually help you is with code completion. So as you're typing code, ChatGPT could actually suggest possible completions for variables, functions, and other code elements. So let's kind of unpack what that means. How can you help with code completion? So I typed in, can you help with code completion? It says, sure, I'd be happy to help with code completion. Can you please provide some more information about what you're trying to do? You create a HTML page with JavaScript that displays weather data for Orlando, Florida. Sure, I'd be happy to help you create an HTML page with JavaScript. Here it's giving the code and it's telling you that you will need to replace the your API key with a valid API key from a weather API provider. Let's ask it, can you recommend a good weather API to use? There's a lot of suggestions here. So popular weather APIs, open weather map, dark sky API, and WeatherBit API. And you add in the code for open weather map API in the above example you shared. And now it's adding in the code with the open weather map API. And then you definitely will need to update your API key with the correct API key. But as you can see, it went and pulled the right weather API URL that's needed. Yeah, it's even telling me you will need to replace the your API key with a valid API key. Pretty powerful. So that's a good example with helping with code completion. There's other things, you know, grabbing code from Stack Overflow, dropping it in here and asking it to do different things on ways that it can rework the code or finding errors. So the second use is actually you can use it for error detection and correction in your code. So as you're writing code, ChatGPT can actually analyze it, alert you for any kind of potential errors with syntax mistakes or undeclared variables. And it even can suggest corrections for those errors, making it easier to write bug-free code. This code to be shorter. So now it's refactoring the code with a shorter version using the Open Weather Map API. And it's a shorter, more condensed version of what's being used up here. So let's look at some of the top questions on Stack Overflow. So how do I undo the most recent local commits in Git? Let's see what pops out here. So to undo the most recent local commits in Git, you use the git revert command. So you can use git log command to view the history of your commits and then use git revert. So in this case, it's telling use git checkout to switch appropriate branch and then run git revert. Yeah, so in this case, the ChatGPT is assuming that it's a public commit with git revert, but it's a good example of showing like you can go to some of these questions on Stack Overflow and plug it into ChatGPT to see what it comes up with. So the third way that ChatGPT can help software engineers is with code explanation. So if you're working on a complex project with so much code, it can actually be difficult to keep track of everything. But with ChatGPT, you can actually ask it to explain any part of the code, and it's going to provide a clear, concise explanation of what it does and how it works. So I asked it, can you help with code explanation? It says, I'd be happy to help you understand any code. Can you please provide the specific code you would like help with? Google.com. Let's view the page source and let's go in here. Can you explain what this code is doing? Now it's explaining what the code is that I just added to it. The code appears to be an implementation of the Google search engine in the form of HTML and contains metadata. So that's pretty interesting. I'm here and let's open up the page source here. Copy this. Can you explain what this code is doing? This code appears to be the HTML for Twitter homepage. Head and body contains body of the document, character set viewport. So let's dive in a little bit deeper into some of the detail. Explain what some of the body is displaying in the code. The body of the HTML document contains content that's displayed on the page. The body appears to contain a header with the Twitter logo and a search bar, as well as a section for signing in, creating new accounts. That's really, yeah, pretty impressive. So a good example here would be if you're just jumping back into a new code base that you're working on as an engineer, you can drop in examples of the code and ask it to explain what that code is doing. And finally, the fourth way that ChatGPT can help software engineers is actually with refactoring code. So as a code base grows and evolves, it actually can be difficult to maintain and improve it over time. But now with ChatGPT, you can actually use it to refactor code, make it more efficient, readable, and maintainable. I did a little bit of example with the refactoring before, talking about like the weather map API, but let's go and grab some code and see what we can do with refactoring it. So I asked it, can you write me HTML and CSS and JavaScript for a personal portfolio page? So now it's telling you, after it outputted this, what you can do with it. Copy this code. This one, image in here. So now we've got simple, just a little card here of a web page in HTML. So let's go ahead and ask it in ChatGPT if it can refactor this code. Refactor this code and make some more improvements with a project area. So I'm asking it to add two or three more projects to the page. So let's copy this, add it in here. And now we've got the list of projects that get added in here. Let's do another tagging on to this and say, can you add in sections of images for each of the project sections? And then it says they've added in the image and you may want to adjust the image using CSS styles, but let's go ahead and drop this in to our code pin here. And you can see placeholder of where that image is going to go. So it's a great example here of showing how the code is able to be refactored with playing around with ChatGPT. Usually it's as simple as just adding things in and seeing what it can come up with. There's a lot more that it can do and it has been doing. I've been testing it out on different things with Svelte and React.js and WordPress, and it has been very impressive. Hopefully we'll be able to do some more content on those specific items and examples here soon. Well, there you have it. That is the top four ways that ChatGPT can help you as a software engineer. Definitely go ahead and check it out at chat.openai.com/chat. We're definitely starting to just scratch the surface of its capabilities. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Make sure you turn on the notification bell for more videos. I'm going to be releasing a lot more AI videos, ChatGPT tech videos. So definitely stay tuned for that. And with that, thanks for tuning in. Remember to keep moving forward, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye-bye.